get the show started!
Recently, Conor McGregor and Kamaru Usman went back and forth on Twitter after the Irishman said that he will go up to 170 pounds and spark the champ. Speaking on the DC and RC show, Daniel Cormier shared his thoughts on the potential bout between the two and explained why it's a smart decision for Usman to accept the fight with McGregor. Here's the clip.
You see that in a lot of fighters, right? Like, you see it in a lot of them. Like, when Jake Paul calls somebody's name, they just rush to it because Jake Paul brings the eyes right now. Conor McGregor says someone's name, they rush to it because Conor brings the eyes always. So if you're Kamaru Usman, and this thing becomes a real possibility if you get through Colby Covington. I will say this on record, as I've said before. Colby Covington is the toughest fight for Kamaru Usman in the welterweight division right now because of his cardio, his pace, his pressure, and his wrestling. He is a very tough fight for Usman, but if Usman gets through Covington again and Conor McGregor fight is an opportunity, why wouldn't he do it? Any person with a brain would do that. Usman fought against Masvidal on 7 days when Masvidal had all the hype, right? When he had been knocking everybody out, got on the plane, stopped in Italy for the pizza, did all that whole thing, and he sold more pay-per-views than he's ever sold in his life. Then he fought him again, right? But he fought him again after fighting Gilbert Burns and seeing the difference in a pay-per-view against a guy that is a very difficult fight but may not have the name and a guy that is a easier fight but has a massive name. So if I'm Kamaru Usman, for my style, I'm definitely taking that or looking into it as an opportunity because you and I both know that Conor McGregor is the biggest star in all of mixed martial arts. And that won't change. Wins, losses, it won't change. He will constantly stay as the marquee name in mixed martial arts.
Speaking on the MMA Hour with Ariel Helwani, Darren Till said he's confident he will become UFC champion one day and will be the one to dethrone UFC middleweight champion Israel Adesanya. I will take 20 losses, I will take 55 losses, I will take injury after injury after injury to get where I want to be. I am prepared to do whatever it takes with me and my team. I have visualizations of winning that belt. Listen, good luck Izzy on your journey. He's a fan of me and I'm a fan of him. But I will be beating you, Izzy. I will be beating you, mate. You know it. Do you guys think Darren Till would beat Israel Adesanya if they fight? Let us know in the comments section. Conor McGregor and Michael Bisping have been going back and forth over the past few days. The beef started after Bisping shared his take regarding Conor's online feud with Daniel Cormier. Then, the Irishman fired back and went on to label The Count as being a nobody. Speaking on his Believe You Me podcast, Bisping joked that McGregor's legacy was disappearing faster than his tweets. Here's the clip.
I couldn't care less. And now, oh, and then he's like, oh yeah, every time he fights, I collect a commission on his fights. Yoink, every time. No, you don't. No, you don't. You have never collected a penny of commission off me, mate. And I'm not going into details, but that's just that. I don't know what's getting deleted Twitter quicker. This was going to be my response. I don't know what's getting deleted quicker. Connor's tweets or his legacy? Because they're both disappearing down the pipe. But still, there you go. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to get into it publicly on social media like I'm arguing with some 13-year-old kids on Call of Duty. You know what I mean? Yeah. I'm a grown man. I'm a commentator. I'm retired. It's not a good look for the UFC if I'm going back and forth with their biggest star on social media. It's childish, you know? So well, like, whatever.
McGregor obviously wasn't happy with these comments from Bisping and issued the following response on Twitter. The only legacy I give a f**k about is the Legacy 5000 my mother flies around on. Money doesn't make you a man, little guy. Besides, even if you stood on your wallet, I'd still be a bigger man than you. Oh, you're a big man, are you, bro? A real man wouldn't sprint from his hometown after they come knocking on his mother's door, bro. Don't forget that one big man in the US, crunch time and you dipped. I'm not your bro. Knock, knock. Who's there? Not Mike, anyway. He's just on the back wall. What do you guys think about this back and forth between McGregor and Bisping? Leave your comments below. One of these planned fights is between two of the most dangerous knockout artists at 205 pounds. On October 2nd, Thiago Santos will take on fellow light heavyweight Johnny Walker. As the fight will be the main event of the night, it is scheduled for 5 rounds. BJPenn.com reports that Dan Hooker will meet Nasrat Haqparast on September 25th. Hooker vs. Haqparast will be a part of the UFC 266 card inside the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas. The report notes that contracts have been sent to both men. Hooker is the 8th-ranked lightweight and is coming off a first-round KO loss to Michael Chandler at UFC 257 in January. Haqparast is unranked but is on a 2-fight winning streak. Haqparast is coming off back-to-back decision victories over Rafa Garcia and Alex Munoz. After retaining his middleweight title last Saturday, Bellator champion Gegard Mousasi spoke to Dean Thomas and RJ Clifford on SiriusXM about his next potential opponent and shared his thoughts on what he thinks of a bout versus Austin Vanderford. Here's what he said.
Well, I mean, maybe a rematch with Lovato Jr. would be seem to be ideal, right?
100%, but I don't think he's going to be cleared to ever fight again. At least he's trying, but that guy with his brain issue, I don't think he's going to get cleared to fight. I have now Vanderford next. He's 11-0. There's always going to be the new guys. But middleweight, the problem middleweight is they're not very well-known names. You know, 2 times Rory McDonald came up, Douglas Lima, and Bellator like that because they have bigger names.
Yeah.
You know, they want to have big fights. The problem is middleweight. You have Yoel Romero now, but he's now light heavyweight. So eventually he will come down and that's going to be a fight. Well, he has a style to beat me 100%. Stand up, I'm better. Ground and pound, I'm better. Grappling, I feel I'm better. It just have the wrestling and he holds you down and do some ground and pound. So yeah. Definitely a serious opponent. I just need to get up if he takes me down. You know, that's the only thing I have to worry about this fight. Yeah, he's good. You know, he's definitely, you know, you can lose any fight. But I feel if I come and show up and fight, there's not a lot of people in middleweight that can defeat me.